Hey guys, Crazy Cosmo here again. So, now that The Force Awakens has opened and it's been a little bit into the weekend, I wanted to come back and I have a new theory that has come to me. Unfortunately, this theory, I should probably start by saying, it kind of refutes the Lumpawaru version of the Jar Jar theory. I should probably be specific here. I've gotten a lot of comments on my Jar Jar theory that are talking about Jar Jar as a Force user. Talking about Jar Jar as like the supreme ultimate ruler of everything. A lot of people are thinking he's Supreme Leader Snoke. My version of the theory is slightly different. I don't know if I actually got it out as eloquently as I would have liked, but I don't actually think Jar Jar was a Force user. I think Jar Jar was more of a spy. He was more of a person convinced to stay close to the Jedi. I don't think he was actually part of the planning phase, as per se. I think he was just more of the vehicle by which the plan was carried out. So here's first of all, I should probably mention that in order to do this, I do have to give some spoilers. So at this point, if you have not yet seen Star Wars: The Force Awakens, do yourself a favor and turn off the video. I don't want to ruin it for you. I apologize if you don't hear this part or if you ignore it. And choose to continue on the video because I do have to give some spoilers in order to make my theory work. So, as I said, a lot of people are making the contention that Jar Jar Binks is actually Supreme Leader Snoke. Now, I don't think that's the case. There are a couple of things in the movie that actually lead me to believe this. Now, my theory is a little bit ill-formed because I only have the one movie to draw from, so I only have a little bit of limited information. But there are a few things that lead me to believe that I have a possibility for a thought on who Supreme Leader Snoke might be. Now, the first thing that we all need to understand is, and we all saw it, Supreme Leader Snoke is only ever seen to us as a hologram, right? Now, up until this point, the hologram has always been the actual physical being just projected. But we all know from other things that we've seen and read in the Star Wars galaxy, even though they may not necessarily be canon anymore, it is possible to slice into a holo projector and project any image you want. So I don't necessarily think that the physical image of Supreme Leader Snoke is the image that is projected before Kylo Ren. So with that being said, the first part of my theory has to do with Kylo Ren himself. Now, as I said, spoiler alert, before I even say this, I'm going to give you guys another five count to turn off the video if you haven't done so yet. One, two, three, four, five. Okay, spoilers abound. Kylo Ren, as we all know, is actually Ben Solo, Han and Leia's son. Now, Leia specifically states during the movie that Supreme Leader Snoke was the one to seduce Kylo Ren to the dark side. Now, having the history that the Solo family has, they are by all rights and purposes, they are a couple of almost royalty. In Leia's case, she was royalty. So, my question is A, how could it possibly be Jar Jar Binks? Because in order to sway him to the dark side, that person would have had to have nearly unfettered access to Ben Solo. Therefore, I think it had to be somebody close to the family, somebody they knew, somebody they trusted, somebody who they would give that access to their son. Now, we know that Luke wasn't the one to do it, or at least we would guess that Luke wasn't the one to do it from all the things that have been dropped along the way. But second part of it, I think we all kind of got the hint that the trilogy was kind of pointing us towards, unless it was another giant misdirect by J.J. Abrams like he did with the whole Finn Rey thing. But I think Rey is actually supposed to be Luke's daughter. Now, if that's the case, that means that there has to be somebody else because, unlike Anakin, I don't think they're going to start playing around with the whole idea of the virgin birth again. So, there is a mother out there somewhere. Now, you might be seeing where I'm going with this. I think that Supreme Leader Snoke is actually Luke's either ex-wife, former paramour, whatever you want to call it. I don't know what name they're going to use for her, so right now I'm just going to go with the name that they used in the EU, Mara Jade. I think Mara is going to be the one who ends up being Supreme Leader Snoke. Now, there's a couple of other reasons why I believe this to be the case. I did a lot of thinking about the First Order. The First Order is a uniform organization, right? They indoctrinate everybody from birth. They take you away from your parents. You eschew your family. You indoctrinate yourself. You swear fealty to this new family, the Jedi. You agree to their tenets. You agree to their their way of thinking. Now, we attribute this with the Sith because they, you know, Kylo Ren has a red lightsaber. But really, if you stop and think about it, this is not the way the Sith acted. They weren't indoctrinating. They wanted you to come willingly. They wanted you to pledge yourself to the dark side of the Force, because those who fall willingly are inevitably more powerful than those who have to be forced. The Jedi are the ones who actually do the indoctrination. If they find out you're Force sensitive, they take you away from your family. They tell you you're not allowed to fall in love. They tell you you're not allowed to do this. You're not allowed to do that. You're not allowed to do the other thing. They take away your individuality. They put you in a uniform. To me, the First Order shares more in common with the tenets of the Jedi than they do with the tenets of the Sith. Therefore, I think Supreme Leader Snoke came out of the teachings of the Jedi, not the teachings of the Sith. They taught the Sith teachings to Kylo Ren, but imperfectly. And we can definitely tell that whoever trained Kylo Ren was not a true master. A true master would have been able to teach him how to create a correct lightsaber. You can see the sparks flying, you can see the exhaust ports in the lightsaber because it hasn't been done correctly. The final piece to this puzzle that I think so far says to me that there's a possibility that Leia's wife could have hidden herself away as Supreme Leader Snoke is the almost paternal interest she takes in Kylo Ren. Now, for somebody in such a powerful position to repeatedly forgive not only failure, but failure and an absolute unwillingness to follow the orders that were given. I mean, several times Kylo Ren actually goes directly against an order that he's given in order to find the map to Luke Skywalker. And, you know, they talked about destroying the droid, they talked about this, but he had to get it. And yet every time he's forgiven. They make jokes, they make insults, but never is he actually punished for anything. Even when he throws a temper tantrum and destroys an entire console on a Star Destroyer, there's no punishment. You know, it seems like, to me, the favorite nephew syndrome. Now, I could be very wrong. I'll admit that up front. As I said, I only have a very little bit of information about this one, and I've just really started putting it together. But I wanted to get my thoughts out there because, you know, the iron is hot. And I'm going to throw this up, and hopefully you guys will like it. If you do, please like it, send it to your friends. If you don't, send it to your enemies. I'll be back with a couple of other things. There were some cool things I noticed in The Force Awakens that I would like to talk about once I get them all together. There were a lot of parallels and a lot of cool little Easter eggs that I saw that I'd like to go put a video together about. But there's always next time. Anyways, take care and may the Force be with you.